In the context of land sparing and land sharing, it is also interesting and relevant to discuss the position and role of so-called organic agriculture. In the next slides, we define conventional agriculture as the mainstream type of agriculture in which artificial inputs are not excluded. So mineral fertilizers or pesticides are used, either in small or larger amounts. Organic agriculture does not use artificial fertilizers, nor pesticides or herbicides. And it does not accept the use of genetically modified organisms. It puts a lot of emphasis on ecological processes to maintain long-term soil fertility and to maintain agriculture and natural biodiversity. In this slide, we show how much land is needed to produce one slice of bread. In the Netherlands, mainstream agriculture would require about 3 times the bread slice area of a wheat crop. Organic wheat production relies largely on manure and natural waste to prevent pests and diseases. On an average, organic crops will yield 20% less than conventional crops if supplied well with manure. So we now need 4 times the bread slice area of a wheat crop. However, for the production of the manure, also land is needed. The cows need grassland and perhaps concentrates to feed themselves. Accounting also for that land implies that we need about 8 to 10 bread slices of agricultural land to produce our one slice of bread. By using the livestock to produce manure, we also obtain 1/4 glass of milk. So while it is possible to achieve high yields of crops grown with organic methods, this will require significant areas of additional land to produce the nutrients that the crops need. The nutrients come from manure, which requires animals to be fed, or from legumes that are able to fix nitrogen from the atmosphere and bring extra nitrogen in the agriculture system. But the legume crops also require land area. So a fair comparison of conventional and organic types of agriculture involves many issues. We need to account for the nutrient availability and the nutrient cycling at the entire systems level. We must account for yield levels at crop level and at the entire system level, including the land needed for livestock and for legumes. And we must take into account all environmental aspects of both types of agriculture, not just the land area. And other environmental factors may include nutrient emissions, the use and emissions of pesticides or not, greenhouse gas emissions, the use of finite resources such as energy or phosphorus. All these environmental criteria must be assessed per unit area and per unit of agriculture product to arrive at the total environmental impact of our food production.